Ladies and gentlemen, this is an article that came out in The Blast, November 29th, 2018. George Zimmerman's stalking victim demands his concealed weapon license be revoked. Unbelievable. The man, George Zimmerman, was convicted of stalking, is now demanding that Zimmerman's ability to carry a concealed weapon in public be prohibited, citing his erratic mental state and penchant of violence. And he claims the state of Florida failed to follow its own laws. Dennis Warren is a private investigator who tracked down potential participants for Trayvon Martin, Rest in Power, the docuseries, co-executive producer by Jay-Z and Michael Gasparo. Warren was on the receiving end of a barrage of threatening messages during the process, including over 185 text messages, which contained threats on his life and his family. Zimmerman was eventually criminally charged with stalking and plead no contest to a misdemeanor offense earlier this month. I don't see how that's a misdemeanor. You threaten to kill people. You threaten to kill this man's family, and that's all you get is a misdemeanor. Ooh, Florida, you and your laws. He was sentenced to 12 months supervised probation. That is not a punishment. That's not no damn punishment. Them and their criminal system got to go. And ordered to stay away from Warren and his family for 10 years. Additionally, Zimmerman was ordered not to possess any guns for 1 year. But Warren claims officials failed to follow the proper procedure to limit his access to weapons, and he wants answers. Warren has sent a letter to obtain by the Blast to the Florida Department of Agriculture Commission, Adam Putnam, the Florida official who heads the agency responsible for issuing concealed carry permits. Warren claims that Zimmerman's concealed carry license should have been temporarily suspended when he was criminally charged with stalking back in March 2018 and then revoked until the year 2022. Until his conviction earlier this year, upon his conviction earlier this year. He's citing a statute, FS 790.063. The state's gun owner license will be suspended if they are charged with a violent crime constituting a misdemeanor, which include stalking. Oh, well, see, he got him right there. Moreover, the department will revoke a license if someone is convicted of the crime until 3 years. Wow. Well, he's convicted of that crime on probation. Y'all gave him some easy shit. After they've finished serving their sentence in probation, the PI believes the Florida Department of Agriculture never suspended or revoked Zimmerman's license and is calling for immediate action be taken on this matter. Warren believes Zimmerman is a continued danger to the community and is sending him out in public with the ability to conceal a loaded weapon could be fatal. He included 7 documented incidents of violence involving Zimmerman, including physical altercations, since 2012, death of 17-year-old Trayvon Martin. He also says Mr. Zimmerman's propensity for violence, coupled with his self-proclaimed mental health issues and financial issues, should give rise for further close evaluation and scrutiny as to any possible future eligibility to obtain a concealed weapons permit, adding that the so he wants it revoked for the mandatory 3-year period. So that's what he's saying. Warren says the letter has been sent to the office of the commissioner, who faced massive criticism earlier this year after it was discovered his department failed to run national background checks on applicants for concealed weapon permits for 1 year, resulting in, so they had to revoke 300 permits because they failed to do a background check. He has yet heard back on a decision. All right, so they're saying, here's his letter. All right. Yeah, well. All right. So what I will do, I will leave the link to the article and this letter that was filed with the commissioner in Florida, so you can review it. But please tell me what you think, ladies and gentlemen. Please leave your comment and subscribe. Don't forget to hit on the notification bell, and I'll see you on the next video. Peace, family.